So American identity to me doesn't mean anything. I don't believe there's any such thing as something that is homogeneous or something that's even cohesive. And when I think of the United States, I just think of the different ethnic groups that are here, and I think of all the oppression that many have faced throughout the entire
seem to assume that there is like a monolithic African culture when in actuality there are several different ethnic groups within African culture. You have your African Americans, you have your native born Africans, then you have the West Indians, which is the group that I'm in, you know, and within that culture there's several different subcultures.
I never say I'm American, and even if I travel abroad I'll still say I'm Puerto Rican, although that's difficult because I always feel I'm walking like on this thin line between the American or white world and the Puerto Rican world and what that means.
Because people recognize that my name is, you know, not, obviously it's not African American like from here, from this country, I got a lot of questions like, you know, where are your parents from, or, oh, and then when I tell them, you know, my parents are Nigerian, the next question is usually, oh, well, did you guys live in a hut? You know, did you have elephants as pets? You know, that kind of thing. Like, they just associate all Africans with that, you know, mindset, that like tribal, non-colonized mindset.
A lot of people don't know where Barbados is, so whenever I have to explain to somebody, you know, that my parents are from Barbados, you know, I have to actually, you know, sit down with them and explain where Barbados is. You know, because when you say Caribbean, you know, they automatically assume Jamaica, and
most people just assume that it's Mexican because they had dark hair. But they couldn't. It seemed like they couldn't even like wrap their head around the fact that I was Muslim and Pakistani. Like, it just seemed like too complicated for most people to understand.
Yeah.
You see, here in America, it's not a question whether we tolerate minorities. America is minorities.
It's funny because we have like our own like little tiffs going on with each other. Like, Trinidadians don't like Barbadians, who don't like Jamaicans, who don't like Haitians, and it just goes on and on, and it's really trivial nonsense. But again, all that stuff is irrelevant when people are just kind of lumping us all together and just call us black.
I don't fit in anywhere. To begin with, I'm very racially ambiguous to many people. And I've gotten everything from like, wow, I didn't know Puerto Ricans come as light as you, to you're like a coconut, you're brown on the outside, you're white on the inside. And a lot of that is, you know, this tie of being Puerto Rican to language, and when you don't speak Spanish fluently, you're deemed to be less of, you're deemed to be turning your back on your heritage.
There was one incident about 2 years ago when I was just walking down the street. I had made a deposit at a bank and was going down to my mother's bank to make a deposit for her, and this police car just pulled up on the corner, and two officers came out and with their handguns drawn and, you know, frisked me and all this other stuff. It turned out that my bank had just been robbed, like maybe 2 minutes after I'd left it, and, you know, I fit the description.
Last time I went back to Nigeria was the summer before I went to high school, so it was a while ago. But me and all my brothers and sisters went back, and we went to the village where both of my grandparents are from. So we had most of our stay, our entire summer was there. And we were obviously automatically, you know, the kids and like all the adults, everyone there could pick out that we weren't born in Nigeria. Not even, you know, before they even had a conversation with us or even came even close to us, they could tell that we weren't from there.
I kind of realized that Pakistan, like, if you grow up as the child of an immigrant, your parents and your older relatives, they always refer to the way things are done in Pakistan, but they sometimes tend to forget that they haven't been there in like almost 3 decades. So the country where they're from has changed so much, like since they left.
Mm-hmm.
But like for them, since they came here when they were young, that period of time is just frozen.
Touch of blue blood and a little bitty bit of red Indian boy. Curly black and king kiss mixed with yellow chinkies. If you lump it all together, well, you got a recipe for a get-along scene.
Oh, what a beautiful dream.
If it could only come true.